Hello everybody, welcome to judycentral.com online classes for law exams. So today I'll be discussing with you the cutoff for DU LLM entrance test of the year 2021 that recently held by the help of previous year cutoff of 2020. So let us start. So first I'll deal with you what are the eligibility criteria for this entrance category. The course requirements are a 3-year or 5-year LLB degree from the University of Delhi or any other Indian or foreign university recognized as equivalent by the University of Delhi, or candidates appearing in the qualifying degree examination are also eligible to appear in the LLM entrance test. So you need to have a degree of 3-year or 5-year which is actually recognized by any other foreign university, or it can also be from the University of Delhi or any other university situated in the country. Then we'll talk about the marks requirement. For unreserved category, candidates at least 50% marks or an equivalent grade point in the aggregate grade in the qualifying degree examination. So if you belong for an unreserved category, then make sure that you have at least 50% marks in your final examination. For SC, ST, OBC, CW, that means widows and defense of wards personals, PWBD category, candidates at least 45% marks or an equivalent grade point in the aggregate in the qualifying degree examination. And if you belong from this reserve categories, then a relaxation of 5% has been given to you. And also those candidates who are in their final year of BLLB years can also appear in this examination. Then we'll talk about the LLM entrance test, the scheme of this test. So like most of you have appeared in this test and you all are well aware that this time the examination has been held by NTA, National Testing Agency, and it was in online mode. And there were a total number of 100 questions and the total time was 2 hours. Then it's actually a subjective type paper in which the following subjects were given, like constitutional law of India, jurisprudence, law of contracts, sale of goods, law of torts, consumer protection, criminal law, family law, public international law, intellectual property law, cyber law, environmental law, then company law and partnership act. So this year also you almost had have witnessed all the the questions from all these topics, from all these subjects, and also you have noticed that the questions were there from Transfer of Property Act, which is not mentioned in the syllabus, but it that subject was very, very important for this DU LLM entrance examination. And also in the next year you may witness questions from TPA. And probably most of you are also aware of this fact that each questions were carrying 4 marks and there was a negative mark of 1. So like if you are answering any question correct, then you will be awarded 4 marks, and if that question is going wrong, then a mark of 1 will be deducted, and the total marks were 400. So now I'll deal with you the seat matrix, and let me tell you, in the information bulletin of the year 2021, although the seat matrix has not been mentioned, I have taken this information from the information bulletin of the year 2020, the previous year, and this seat matrix has been given on the website of Law Faculty of Delhi University. You can also refer the same. So I am just contemplating that this year also the seat matrix will be just the same as the previous year. So if there is any addition or if there is any reduction of any seats, then obviously the university will be informing you within no time. So let us see the seat distribution for LLM admissions. So first I'll start with the category called UR, that means unreserved, and there are two kinds of LLM that DU is actually offering to you. First is LLM 2 years and the second one is LLM 3 years. So 2 years is actually a regular course and 3 years is actually made for professionals. But let me tell you, there is no difference between the 2 years and the 3 years LLM. There is only addition of one more year in the what do you call the professional categories, but altogether there is no such difference between the degree of 2 year and 3 year. So for unreserved, if I talk about LLM 2 years, then the seats are 27 and 3 years once, the seats are 24, total 51. If I talk about OBC, for LLM 2 year you have 18 seats, for LLM 3 year you have 16 seats, that means total of 34 seats. For SC, there are 10 seats for 2 year and 9 seats for 3 year, total is coming to 19. ST, 5 for LLM 2 year seats, 4 for LLM 3 year seats, total is 9. For EWS, 7 seats are reserved for LLM 2 year and 5 seats are reserved for LLM 3 year, total is coming to 12. So now if I talk about the total number of seats, then for LLM 2 year you have a total number of seats including the reserved ones are 67, and for LLM 3 year you have a total number of seats including the reservations are 58. And then additional, there are certain additional reservation given to PWD and widows and wards of defense personnel. So if I talk about PWD, then in LLM 2 year you have 3 number of seats, and in LLM 3 year you have also 3 number of seats, that means total number of 6 seats. And for CW, for defense and widows of ward personnel, you have 3 seats in LLM 2 year and also 3 seats in LLM 3 year, that means 6 seats each for PWD and CW category. So now I'll talk with you about the schedule of fees. That is, this schedule of fees is from the year 2020 to 2021. So I'm not sure that whether they'll increase this fee structure, because I am just sharing the details with you according to the previous year information given on the website of Law Faculty of DU. So there might be certain variations. So if I talk about fee for PWD students, it is only 75. Fee for students already enrolled with University of Delhi, that means if you have done your LLB from University of Delhi, or if you are actually enrolled, that's what it means, that if you have done your LLB from DU LLB, or if you are in the final year of Delhi University LLB program, then your fees will be rupees 5,579. And fee for students already not enrolled with the University of Delhi, that means if you haven't done your LLB from University of Delhi, then you need to pay 5,729. For MCL students, that means for foreign category students, it is actually rupees 5,729 plus $200. And for SC/ST students whose parents are exempted from paying income tax, they only have to pay rupees 105 less. And fee concession for EW students, if any, will be as per university directions. So it actually means that if at all they are offering any concession to EWS students, they will inform you within no time. Then I'll talk about with you the cutoff of 2020. So this cutoff is actually taken from the website of Law Faculty of Delhi University, and this is the first admission list of LLM 2020. And before discussing this thing with you, let me tell you, if I talk about this year's question paper, then I would say that obviously the paper pattern was just the same like the previous year ones, but I would say that this time it was not very difficult. Why I'm saying this, because there were repetition of previous year questions. If you have watched my sessions in which I have discussed with you the previous year question paper of DU LLM, you might have encountered this thing, that the questions were actually repeated from the previous year. So that this is a reason why I would say again, the level of questions were from moderate to hard level. And obviously I am actually according to my opinion, I would say like the cutoff which actually went out previous year will be just the same for this year also. So let me tell you the cutoff of 2020, and also I'll tell you that yes, there might be slight variations, like what I have seen for the last 5 years, their cutoff actually keep on increasing. So you may, witness a change of 5 to 10%, but not more than that. But actually, what my personal feelings are, like whatever the cutoff went out the previous year, will be just the same for this year also. So if I talk about the unreserved, the first and the last ranked final entrance marks. So let me tell you, the first rank holder got 291 out of 400, and if I talk about in percentage, then the percentage was 72.75%. And the last person secured 227 marks. I'm not saying about the ranking, it is about the marks. 227 marks, and out of 400, the percentage is actually standing to 56.75. If I talk about OBC non-creamy layer, the first rank holder got 230, and in percentage he secured 57.5 out of 400, and the last person secured 181. In percentage it is 45.25. if I talk about SC schedule caste, first rank holder secured 193. In percentage it is 48.25 out of 400, and the last person secured 151 marks, and if I convert it in percentage, it is coming to 37.75 out of 400. Then I'll talk about the ST categories. First rank holder secured 190, that means 47.5 out of 400, and the last person secured 104, that is 26 out of 400, that means 26% out of 400. And if I talk about EWS, the first rank holder secured 224, in percentage it is 56%. And the last person secured 183, that means 45.75% out of 400. And now I'll discuss with you the cutoff of third admission list. And let me tell you, in their website I didn't find the cutoff of the second admission list. There were only two lists uploaded on the website. First, the first admission list and the third admission list, and the second admission list was missing. So let me tell you, for unreserved, first rank holder secured 230, that means 57.5%, and the last person secured 204, that means 51%. For scheduled caste, the first person secured 151 and the last person secured 141, that means if I convert 151 into percentage, it means 37.75, and the last person who secured 141, if I convert it into percentage, it is coming to 35.25%. If I talk about EWS, the first rank holder secured 196 marks, that means 49% out of 400, and the last person secured 162 marks, that means 40.5% out of 400. And let me tell you, in the third cutoff list, there were no rankings for ST categories and OBC category. For both of these categories, there were no mention of there were no mention of cutoff in the third admission list. So now I'll talk about with you the poll which I conducted on my channel. And in this poll I have asked all of you how many questions you attempted today at DULLM entrance exam. So already 118 people have voted, and in which more than 90 questions, 43% of people have attempted. And if I talk about questions between 75 to 85, 49% of the people have attempted the questions between 75 to 85, and only 8% have attempted less than 70. Then I can actually say that, like, most of you, those hardworking people are only there on my channel, because if I talk about this poll, this is actually really surprising, because like 43% have attempted more than 90 questions, and there are 75 to 85 questions have been attempted by 49% of you, and only 8% of you have attempted less than 70 questions. So I can see a big improvement from your side. So this is the session for today, and I hope you all have liked it. Do not forget to like, share, and subscribe to the channel. So till we meet the next time, thank you and have a nice day.